I use these picks. These are made by Red Bear. These are ridiculously expensive picks. They're made out of a mystery compound. I don't know exactly what it is. It's some kind of blend of formaldehyde and fermented dairy products. And you are advised, when you buy one of these picks, there's a little piece of paper that comes with it. It says, don't get your pick wet. Strange things happen if you get them wet. But apart from that, they sound and look and behave a lot like turtle shell, but you don't have to kill any turtles, which is peace and love, man. It's good not to kill turtles if there's an option. And they last for a really long time. So I like them for that reason. They're pretty heavy duty. You wouldn't really want to try and bend it. Amongst other things, it would snap before it bent. But it seems to me you get a wider dynamic range that way. If you've got a soft, floppy pick, it's good for a certain kind of acoustic, folky, strumming stuff. Sometimes records really nicely with a thin pick. But if you want one pick that will serve you for all of your needs, I think something vaguely pointy, something quite thick, is the way forward. Your loud notes can be louder, and you can still get a quiet note if you really need one. So that's what works for me. I'm not saying it's right for everyone, but now you know my dark secrets. Red Bear pick.